Hey Sonne, meine Kinder, wir haben Black and White Camera Episode 24. This episode was way more better than the last few episodes, like the last two episodes. So it all starts out this weird already. And we learned that Daiji is not that important anymore. Like, he doesn't even get like a real mission or something. He just sits down in floors, gets mad at Vice and Tamaki for creating a mess. So Tamaki starts to work at, well, here, and they make a real mess. Vice's ghost is out of control sometimes, and Tamaki has a cringy smile, and that's why he has a red face right now. He got punched by Vice accidentally. So the story is, it's been a week since Ikki and Vice changed positions, and we learn later on that Ikki hasn't ate anything for a week already, so I have no idea how he still survived. I mean, he is still a human being after all, but he hasn't ate anything for a week already. And George says later on that Ikki can die if he doesn't eat, and then Vice can die also then. Then there's George. George came in, talked to Sakura about the Ushijima family, just talked about, hey, weird boy, family, organization. I forgot what he said, but he said something about weekend. Sakura just... So she leaves right away. And then George wants to take, you know, a hot bath. But he wants Genta to help him. Here is why he wants Genta to help him. Here, this is Genta on the back. See that scar there? George is asking about the scar. He's asking like how he got that. Genta, of course, forgot. And then Karizaki said, that scar must be really deep, huh? Inside his mind, he's obviously thinking about the heart. Of why he doesn't have a heart while Gif has a heart. So that's still a mystery for Karizaki, though. And you go to the Deathman's base where their mission is still to defeat Life and Jan. Well, they have the chance. Well, Ikki and Vice are going crazy, but what they don't know is, well, Vice can control already. But in this episode, they want to kidnap George. So they're switching the missions already. The last episode was they wanted to destroy Jan and Life. Now they want to kidnap George so the Demon's Driver can be more powerful. I don't know why Orteka will trust George just like that. He says that he will take any risk. How dangerous it is, he'll just take it. Super dangerous, still taking it to be more stronger. So then he stamps his assistant that's been with him for like since episode like 16, I think. Or did she change? Nah, I think she didn't. We don't see Dr. Akemi again, though. Okay. And then they go to George again. Well, George explains that Ikki has to, well, eat or else he'll die. So they get worried now. And then George says that to get Ikki back to his original form as a human form and switch places with Vice back, he has to scan the Rex Vice Stem onto the Rolling Vice Stem so Ikki's soul can be inside the Rolling Vice Stem, and when Vice wants to henshin again, it will be upside down, because the first time when Ikki wants to henshin, he just rolls himself, suddenly Vice controls him. So if it's upside down, well, he can do it again just with the Rex Vice Stem this time. But of course, Vice has to do it, and then Ikki will switch upside down again. And everything will be resolved again. But the problem is Vice doesn't trust George because of what happened to Hiromi. He doesn't want Ikki to, well, die, and he will die. He wants to protect Ikki. He doesn't trust George anymore. And then Sakura goes to Weekend again, where the guy that looks like Shroud reveals himself as Karizaki Masumi, or George's dad. So there's a lot of things that's going on in this episode. So there's you could say two parts to this episode. George's kidnapping part and the wild mystery of Weekend part. There's only two scenes with Weekend, but they really make our mind think very hard. Why is Masumi Karizaki, the dad of George, still alive? And how does George not know about this yet? I mean, he knows already, but how did he know and when did he know? So he reveals to himself as Masumi Karizaki or George's dad. And yep, he was the one that made the rolling vice stamp. So Sakura asks him if Iki can turn back, of course. And then, who's the name again? Hikaru's fake dad. Yeah, Hikaru's fake dad. So they're a fake family. The mom, the dad, and Hikaru are a fake family. Hikaru's fake dad. I forgot the name. Was it like Ushijima Tasue or something? Tasue, I think. Okay. So he says that Gif and the dead man are together forever. Nothing can separate them. So if Gif gets like a reaction, then like if Gif gets a reaction, like any reaction, like power going in him or he gets hurt or something, then all the devils like Lovecuff, Kagero, Vice will have a headache, and that will affect their user by maybe unhenching or also having a headache like Daiji will in this episode. So then I don't know how, but George is clearly a mastermind. There's a lot of things I like about George here. He's a clear mastermind. He has a lot of mysteries. And then he's George, he's fun. And then fourth, I forgot. What was I going to say? How could I forget what I was going to say? Fourth, I think I was going to say something like, I don't know. What is wrong with me? Okay, but he's kind of some kind of wizard that knows everything. How? I don't know. He knows where Sakura and Hikaru are talking right now. And then he just says, tell me the secret about your family and your organization. And why my dead dad is still alive. Well, supposedly that dead dad is still alive. Like, why? That mystery is, well, not yet solved yet. And then suddenly, a Giftarian attacks. Well, the Giftarian that Ortega stamped just now attacked. And then Jan had to protect Karizaki. So she jumped off the building to George's building. Well, Lovecuff got hit by the railing. So she falls down. She tries to go up, shouting, rubber, 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 rubber. She falls again. Kabu. I'm so glad that Lovecuff is back again because the voice actor is all okay again. But the sad thing now is that the user now, the actor of Sakura, is positive now. I don't know, it's just going all together again. All actors of Tokusatsu are getting one by one. Are getting the virus one by one. And then Ortega comes out of nowhere. He just appears. George is so brave. Oh yeah, this is what I forgot. The fourth is George laughs every time in every situation possible. He just laughs. Any situation possible. Even when he got kidnapped, he still ha 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 ha. So Ortega says, make the demon's driver better again or else I'll use force. But I don't know why he took out the Daiwika vice stamp. I mean, his dead man form is out of him already. Well, that's what I know at least. At episode 20, they got his dead man form out of him. Why is he still getting the Daiwika vice stamp? Isn't that like useless now? Or I don't know. But George is really brave. Well, anyway, he still got kidnapped though. And then since the Giftedion got defeated, power goes to Gif. Gif gets a reaction. And Sakura and Vice and Henshins. And Daiji gets a headache while Kagero is there. And then even Karizaki, he got caught. He's still laughing. Ortega wants him to upgrade the Demon's Driver into the true power of the Demon's Driver. Of course, what George did is trick him. So, yeah. George the Mastermind. And then Sakura's fighting with Vice because of Ikki stuff. Vice doesn't believe in Karizaki while Sakura wants him to do the thing that Karizaki asked him. Because if he'll just do nothing and not believe Karizaki forever, then well, bye bye Ikki. So then he gets a call. Sakura gets a call from George telling where they are to trap them to Ortega. But what Ortega doesn't know is, well, he got tripped. And then we see Masumi Karizaki again here, right in front of this. It looks like the Demon's Driver, Well, it's not. We'll get a clearer shot later on. And Ortega gets his spiderweb henshin like Hiromi did in episode 15. Wait. I think it was episode 15. He henshined, fought Sakura until Sakura bashed through, just crashed through a wall. Lovecuff is nowhere to be found again. Maybe she ran, or she's still in that place. Probably not, of course. Ikki gives him some like theories. What Vice says though, that if Vice believes in Ikki and Ikki believes in Karizaki, then that means Vice also believes in Karizaki and that he has to do the thing, something like that. So we kind of get a moment. I don't really, maybe. But then we get this cool thing again where Vice finally believes Karizaki. Scans the Rex Vice Stem onto the rolling Vice Stem. It says Rex Energy. Yeah, I think it was Energy. And then he rolled it at him. Suddenly, a portal opened where Ikki and Vice turns back again. And then Ikki henshins to Kamen Rider Jack Revice. First, I wanted to do this as the thumbnail, but I've done this before with Jack Revice, so yeah. So they fought Ortega again as demons. And then, surprisingly, he tried to use two Genomixes, the Bata and the Scorpion. He does the Bata already. He tries to do the Scorpion. Suddenly, we see this red thing. That's what happened to Hiromi in episode 12 when he tried two Genomixes. Then he blew up. He went out. He got kicked by Sakura and by Ikki. And bye bye. He's still there though. And he realized that Karizaki tricked him. Then, instead of Ikki being fully separated by Vice, I mean, they are one, but like normal again, where Vice comes out of his ear or something, it becomes like this. Ikki and Vice becomes one. Just literally one. So whenever Ikki speaks, he becomes normal Ikki. Whenever Vice speaks, there's horns that come out, and then blue eyes, and then Vice's tail. Well, a new problem. For a new set of three episodes leading to the Thunder Girl debut. Yeah. And then we get a clearer shot of the Demon's Driver 2. I talked about this in the Dear Gaga video where why do they have to make the Demon Driver 2? They just released the Demon Driver in premium Bandai form. And now they're going to release another one. Are they going to release this? Maybe. We're gonna know next Monday. If they release this, please make it normal. Normal DX, not P Bandai. Maybe just like take out some features from the Demon Driver. Like a lot of vice times you can make as Genomix. So maybe just put like 5-10 main ones maybe. And then at the end, we see Orteca holding the Demon's Driver. When, like, a spirit comes out, gets out of the Demon's Driver, says his name is Bale. Kamen Rider Bale will debut in the next episode. So, I have a feeling that Orteca can't become demons anymore. Because the demon, the devil inside is out. The devil inside is called Bale here. He will use the Kuwagata Vice Time to Henshin, but we don't know who the user is yet. We'll figure out in the next episode. So there's another shot of the Demon Driver 2. It's all orange. I mean, it is cool, but like why? It just released. The Demon Driver just released. There. He uses the Kuwagata Vice Time, I think. Okay. Here are some stealths for the next episode also. There's... I don't know what this is. I think since because this episode, the next episode will be about the past of Igarashi Genta and the three Igarashi Kyodai. Maybe this is what George when he was a little kid. Yeah, probably. Or he went back to the past. Nah. That would be too weird. And then there's two Giftarians. Who else could this be now? Who? I don't know who else this could be. Then Bale will hold Iki's head. And then we see his sleeve a bit. It looks like the sleeve of Igarashi Genta in the March scans. So... Are they tricking us again? Or is it actually real this time? You won't know until we watch the episode. Then lastly, we have a still of Vice tapping the head of either Iki or Genta, they say. Pretty sure maybe it's Genta. Because if... Yeah, but why? Yeah, we'll figure out in the next episode. So thank you for watching. Love, share, and comment below what you thought about this episode. I thought this was way more better than the last episode. Next episode is gonna be way more amazing. More mystery is gonna be solved and new rider. Okay, so next video I'm gonna make a video about the new animation of Kamen Rider Double Futo PI. So yeah, can't wait for episode 25.